Hello students, welcome to the 7th part of the chapter Acid, Bases and Salts. Let's start today's session. Today we will start with the acid rain. Rain that contains excess of acids is called acid rain. Acid rain is formed when pollutants like sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide get dissolved. Now children, from where does this sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide comes into the atmosphere? They all come from the, either from the chimneys of the factories or burning of the coal or from the exhausts of the automobiles. There are many other ways by which these pollutants get mixed into the environment. Now when these pollutants get dissolved in raindrops, they form sulfuric acid and nitric acid. That is, when sulfur dioxide get mixed with the water in form of rain, they form sulfuric acid, and when nitrogen dioxide get mixed with the rain water, it forms nitric acid. Now these acids reach the land and rivers with rain shower. Now when this acid rain reaches to the soil, it seeps into the ground. And these acids accumulate in soil and contaminate the nutrients required by the plants for their growth. Now what happens when this acidic water seeps into the ground, it hampers the quality of the soil and also in turn hampers the growth of the plants. Acid rain may also damage monuments and buildings. So, as you can see, this acid rain is very, very harmful for the soil, plants, the aquatic plants and animals, and for the monuments and buildings also. How they are harmful for the monuments and buildings? They can tarnish the metallic material which are present in the monuments or buildings. So this way, this acid rain is very, very harmful for the environment. Now children, this is very, very important thing which we are going to revise over here, that how does these indicators change their colors in acid, medium, base and neutral. We are just revising it over here. Let us revise it first about the China rose, how it behaves in acids, base and neutral. China rose in acid, it turns into magenta color. In base, it turns to green color, whereas in neutral solution, it does not show any change. The second indicator, that is the litmus paper, it turns from blue to red in acidic medium and from red to blue in basic medium. And in neutral solution, there will be no change. That is, the red color litmus paper remains red in the neutral solution and blue color litmus paper will remain blue in the neutral solution. Turmeric. Turmeric indicator, it shows no change in acidic as well as in neutral solution, but it changes from blue to red in basic solution. Methyl orange, it will turn into red color in acidic medium and it remains yellow and in base and neutral solution. The next is phenolphthalein, it will remain colorless in acidic and in neutral solution, whereas it will change into pink color in basic solution. So I hope this table will be helpful for you all. Now this is the practice time. There are three exercises for you all. The first exercise is fill in the blanks. The first one is litmus dye is obtained from dash. You have to name the place from where this litmus dye is obtained. The second is phenolphthalein is dash indicator. You have to tell whether it is synthetic or natural indicator. The third is salt solution is a good conductor of dash. Salt solution means when salt get dissolved in water, it becomes a good conductor of dash. Number four, acidic soil can be neutralized by adding dash. You have to tell the name of that thing by which this acidic soil can be neutralized. Fifth, neutralization is dash evolving reaction. You have to recall what happens when neutralization reaction takes place, that is when acid and bases reacts with each other, salt is formed, water is formed, and what else is being evolved in this reaction, that you have to write it over here. The next exercise is state true or false. Let's see the first one. Hydrochloric acid is present in our stomach, helps in digestion of food. Second, oxalic acid is found in tamarind. Third, bases are colorless liquids. Fourth, baking soda is basic in nature. Fifth, all acids have a sour taste. The next exercise is about answer the following questions. Question number one is, what are basic substances? You have to just define in one sentence, what are basic substances? Second question is, define indicator. And the B part is, define salts. You have to just write in one line, what is an indicator and what is salt over here. Question number three, what is used to test the strength of an acid and a base? That how will you test how strong that acid is, or how strong or weak that acid is, or how strong and weak that base is? Which scale you use, that you have to mention that scale over here. Question number four, give three examples of everyday materials which contain an acid. First, you will give three examples of the things which you use in everyday that that contain acid, and you have to name that acid also. And the three materials you have to give, the three basic materials you have to name, and you have to tell the name of the bases over there also. Question number five, what is neutralization? You have to give the definition of the neutralization over here. How is neutralization helpful in the treatment of indigestion? You have to describe how this neutralization is helpful in case of indigestion. With this, we come to the end of chapter Acid, Bases and Salts. Thank you.